ivory towers, about protecting freedom and democracy of the world while making enemies of Venezuela's elected democratic government and allies with Saudi Arabia's tyrannical, oppressive monarchy. We overthrew a monarchy 200 something years ago. Every single American military intervention throughout the 20th century, even in the crusade against Nazi occupation of Europe, there was a sinister ulterior motive if you just scratch at the surface.
What do you think, dude?
Sauce?
The world's first democratic government be responsible for crimes against humanity, the subversion of the will and the people, in more countries than there are states in the Union? How can this country be responsible for anything but the most admirable displays of solidarity and humanitarianism? Profit! That's how! Profit is the key to understanding this whole mess of the world we live in.
This is not a war by any legitimate historical definition. So quit using the words war on terrorism. What we really know is we have a period of occupation of the people of Iraq. We have a period of occupation of the people of Afghanistan by the people that you and me are the United States. You cannot renounce your responsibility for making a change.
I really think that in most cases, that trusting your government and loving your country are probably mutually exclusive. If you love your country, you're never going to completely trust your government. The power in this is ours. We still live in a country that allows us to do this, allows us to speak out when we see something wrong in an open forum. We need to use that right while we've still got it, or we're going to lose it. The price of freedom is vigilance. You never get to stop. You don't get to sit back just because things are okay.
We do have some striving that we have to do. We have to strive to think nonviolently. We have to strive to speak nonviolently. We have to strive to act nonviolently. We have to strive to do nonviolence. That strife is companioned with love. And that word love, that great beautiful word love, which is also related in the roots of our own language to life. Until we learn to struggle for nonviolence in our thinking and in our speech, until we take away from these people in power, the power to set the rhetoric, and we come forward after demanding peace today to struggle for nonviolence tomorrow and the next day to take back the rhetoric away from the rhetoric of war to the rhetoric of nonviolence to the rhetoric of strife and struggle, to the basic human need to love each other, where we support each other and we strengthen each other. We do not destroy each other. We do not battle each other. We do not combat each other. We do not fight each other. We learn to love. We learn to be nonviolent. We defeat war. There's no need for war if we are nonviolent. So today we demand peace, but tomorrow we begin the struggle for nonviolence. Today we demand that cessation, which will become the extermination of war.
Yeah!
Thank you.
those who start wars. Never fight them. And those who fight wars, they never like them. And those who write laws, they can recite them. And those of us who just fight laws, live and die them. But I know they're never gonna tell you why, no. They only wanna tell you lies, no. Never ever gonna tell you why, no. They only wanna tell you lies, no. Never ever gonna tell you why, no. They only wanna tell you lies. It's time, it's time to go home. Don't take our boys away, no. Don't take our girls away, no. Don't take our boys away, no. Don't take our girls. It's time to go home. Don't take our boys away, no. Don't take our girls away, no. Don't take our boys away, no.